Astral sex. Most people recall having sex dreams sometime in their life. It might not just be dreams. It could actually be a form of actual paranormal sex. When you fall asleep, your soul will naturally eject out of your physical body. This happens every single time when you are asleep. Your soul continues to be asleep outside your body, but at a certain stage your soul self awakens and you would recall it as a dream. Your dream lover will talk with your sleeping soul, telling you how much he or she loves you. Click like if you like and subscribe if you want to subscribe. I wrote a book, Haunted Desire. The link is below. The ghost being can become fluid in form and have the ability to shapeshift into different forms, appearances and even be subtle enough to enter your being and fuse with you or even become, what is called, an attachment. If this happens, an attachment in any form, you will often feel a heaviness and extreme tiredness. This happens due to your aura being invaded. The ghost might not have bad intentions, but it does have an adverse effect on your being, even your persona. Some people reported hearing disembodied voices. Soul lovers, dream lovers, or astral lovers tend to call your name continuously. Many people can recall being seduced under paralysis. Or your sleeping soul, in many instances, will go out of your body and get attracted to a sexual being from the opposite sex. You are surrounded by ghosts all the time. You have attracted a ghostly lover through your own thoughts and feelings for sex. You actually attract a ghost through your vibrations emanating from your thoughts, be it lustful or normal thoughts and aspirations. But you do not only attract ghosts, you also attract other types of beings. The most common lustful entities are known as the lustful female succubus or lustful male incubus. Historians and archaeologists have uncovered ancient Egyptian manuscripts, talking about the evil archon beings. Today they are known as jinn, of which Muslims' texts describe as bad and also good beings. These beings can be good or bad and also have families and a social structure. They do not die, because they do not have a physical body. They indulge in sex with you to suck your energy. They feeds off from your sexual vibrations and even from your suffering. They frequent graveyards. They are also present on battlefield to feed off the dying. There are also extraterrestrial beings from within our realm or outer realms, as well as multidimensional realms and even from the multiverse. There are also monsters from hell who come to you looking for your sexual encounter, willingly or unwillingly. Many of them come to you in an instant. Some come to you through a portal, no matter how far away they may be in the known universe or outside our perception. Many people have reported being seduced in their sleep and even while being awake in a form of paralysis. There were also innumerable reports through the centuries of people being abducted by alien extraterrestrials. These aliens engage in sex with human beings, so a hybrid race could be created. Most of these beings do not have benevolent intentions. Most have evil and sinister agendas. Ancient cultures of Egypt, Sumeria, Lemuria, and others had profound leaning towards the sexual cravings. In the ancient Egyptian Book of the Dead, it is described the importance of sex. Ancient people indulged in bizarre sexual practices and even sex rituals for some reason or another. There is so much happening sexually all around you, but you cannot perceive it simply because your waking state is curbed and limited to a mere 1% of reality. Famous people like movie stars have come forward in public on TV, in magazines and newspapers that they have had bizarre sexual encounters with ghosts. And they brag about it. Humanity has been freed from otherwise outlawed reading material in our postmodern epoch, but are our minds freed? And are we matured enough to withstand seemingly forbidden knowledge? In past centuries, The church outlawed esoteric knowledge and burnt such books, and anyone found with forbidden material faced extreme harsh consequences, to say the least. Some alleged forbidden books have survived through the centuries, and such knowledge was consequently verbally handed down secretly from one esoteric seeker to another. However, this is one of the few books on the topic of paranormal sexual encounter in which the reader can identify himself or herself with. Nevertheless, much has been written already on the esoteric paranormal sexual endeavor by people such as Aleister Crowley, who was an avowed follower of the dark sciences. Crowley, for example, goes into great depth about paranormal sex in his satanic rituals.